Starting of gauge rotor, industrial gauge is the most popular type of rotor we have seen. So here we can have two types of starters. One is going to be a star delta starter, another one is going to be auto transformer starter. So you see here the stator is going to have a star connection and the rotor is going to have conductors all around the cylinder. So same way here, the rotor is going to have conductors all around the cylinder, the stator is going to be a star connected network, and you are going to use auto transformer here for starting. But here I'm going to use star and delta network for starting. Star is present in stator and delta will be present in rotor. So you need to have a star starter or a delta starter. So you can have two types of starters. Either you can start with the star network or you can start with the delta network. Okay, that is star delta starter. Next one is auto transformer starter. So either you can the stator will be having star here, and you're going to use auto transformer for starting your motor. Here I have two options to use, either star or delta, but here I am going to use only one auto transformer for starting my induction motor. The purpose, the mechanism of how it is starting is given in the next slide. So mostly induction motors we have seen to have squirrel gauge rotor only. So it is usual to start the squirrel gauge motors with a reduced voltage. So start with the low voltage, that can be accomplished using star delta starter. So in star delta starter, you see it is the stator is designed for delta connection during normal operation. So you are going to use stator winding with delta connection for normal operation. All the six terminals are brought out and connected as shown in the figure. So see here, stator, six terminals means, in assume that your stator is going to have delta connection, means stator, the both ends of stator are connected to the delta, both ends of RYP. So totally six terminals are connected to the delta part. That is what is given here. Proton are connected as shown here. So using a double pole, double throw tripole switch, the stator is connected to the star. So that voltage is 1/3 times the normal value. See, why we are using this is, I told you the reason above. When you are going to start squirrel gauge induction motors, the voltage should be less. So in which connection voltage is less in star and delta, if you see, means in star connection only the voltage is 1/3 times less. It is 1/3 of the normal value. So what I am going to do, initially my stator is having delta connection, but I am going to connect that to star to reduce my input voltage. So once the motor is picking up speed, the changeover switch disconnects the windings and reconnects them in delta. So for starting, I'll be using a star. For running the motor, I'll be using a delta. That's what is given here. Star start, delta run. Star start means while starting, the switches will be in this position. They will be connected to the star network. After some time, when the motor is running at full speed, the switches will be slowly moving into delta run. Means when the motor is running, the configuration will be delta. So it is called a star delta starter. Okay. So this method reduces the current drawn by 1/3. See, in star the voltage is less, in delta the current is less. Okay, so this ensures that at the starting my voltage is less, so my motor is safe. While running also the motor is safe because the current is also 1/3 times the normal value. So however, the starting torque is also reduced to 1/3. See, torque is proportional to current. If current is reduced, the torque is also reduced. This method is going to be very cheap, but when you require a very high starting torque, this cannot be used because the torque is reduced to 1/3. Normal torque, it will be 1/3 times the lower value. So next one is auto transformer starter. So we are going to use auto transformer to supply the reduced auto transformer. You know, primary and secondary will be in the same winding, and you will have a pointer to say that we upper portion will be primary, lower portion will be secondary. By moving this pointer, I can reduce the voltage. So initially, while starting, the voltage will be very, very less. So once the motor is completely running, the auto transformer is completely cut so that the motor is going to run at full speed. So these two types of starters are available for induction motors. Any doubt you have in star delta starter and auto transformer starter? Any doubt you have, you can unmute yourself and ask.
Sir, can you say that star delta starter one more time, sir?
See, star delta means the, see, everything, the connection is only with the stator. The rotor, no connection we are going to do. See, initially, star delta starter means when the motor is you are going to start your motor, the stator will be connected to the star network because the voltage should be less when you are going to connect your motor directly to your power supply. Because in star, the voltage is only 1 by root 3 times your available value. So the initial starting voltage is less. But once your motor is started using star network and it is going to pick up speed and run at full speed, then you will slowly move the switch from star to delta. Because in delta, you know, the current is going to be 1 by root 3. So the motor will be running safe at 1 by 3, root 3 times the full current. But what drawback you are having here is, you know, torque is proportional to current. So when the current is going to be less, the motor will have a very reduced amount of torque. So for high power applications where you need to have a very high starting torque, you cannot use this star delta starter. And the case, I'll be using this auto transformer starter.
Okay, sir.
That's what it is given here. Star start delta run. Star start means during the starting of motor, I am going to use a star network. When the motor is running, I am going to use a delta network. Again, when the power, suppose the power is going off suddenly, means the motor will be brought back to star position. So whenever the motor is going to start, it is going to be always the star network. Whenever the motor is going to run, it is always going to be with the delta network. In auto transformer, you see, only when the motor is starting, this auto transformer will be inside the circuit. When the motor is running, you will be disconnecting the auto transformer. You will be connecting the motor directly to your main supply. Your switches are given to that purpose. Switches can be either in only one position at a time. They cannot be in both positions. So these switches during starting, they will be in one position. During running, they will be in one position. They cannot be in both the place at the same time. Okay, that is the purpose.